G'day everyone, welcome to Animal Tales with Tim Faulkner. That's me. Today, I'm talking about freshwater turtles. The freshwater turtles throughout the world are facing extinction, and Australia is no exception. Just along the east coast of Australia, from Sydney to Cairns, there are over a dozen species. Most of them are threatened with extinction. I really commonly get asked, what's the difference between a turtle and a tortoise? Turtles to tortoises are easy. Just think, sea turtles have flippers, Galapagos tortoise have feet. And that's one easy way to distinguish between. But Australian freshwater turtles, most are aquatic, meaning they spend all of their time in the water. They don't have flippers, but their feet are webbed. And so they're kind of between, but they fit within turtles. Australian freshwater turtles, like all turtles, they have a shell, a protective shell. And you think one of their predators are sea eagles. So a sea eagle comes down and tries to grab that turtle. First of all, it's hard for the sea eagle to grab onto its shell because it's slippery. The shell is then used to protect the turtle if it's exposed. So the turtle pulls into its shell, like I'm sure we've all seen. And that shell is a really great defensive system. Now let's start with some of the features around their head. Now, some turtles have a couple of little feelers here on the chin, and their eyes have reasonable vision. Not great, but reasonable. They still have ears, not like ours, but if you look on the side of the head, you can see like a little satellite dish. And remember, sound travels a lot further and faster underwater, so the hearing is actually quite good. They breathe through their nostrils. Okay, so all turtles breathe air. But let's go right to the other end, down to their tail. Have you ever heard a turtle called a bum breather? They really are. What happens is they actually extract oxygen from the water as well as breathe air. But some species of Australian freshwater turtle can stay underwater for hours. And what they actually do is open their cloaca and they draw water in, and they can extract oxygen from that water. So there are two mechanisms for extracting oxygen from air and water. Are their feet? Are webbed, and that obviously helps for swimming. And they've also got reasonable claws. Underwater, they could scratch away to try and find food, but also females, when they're nesting, they need to dig a hole to lay their eggs in. All of Australia's freshwater turtles are mostly aquatic. They spend their entire lives in water. Now, there are some exceptions, like the long-necked turtle or snake-necked turtle. Now, it prefers to live in dams or drainage lines, and it'll cover lots of ground, move across the land to find different bodies of water. And it actually prefers that than being in a flowing river. And the flowing river is where you'll find a lot of your short-necked turtles. Now, there's a difference in the way that they hunt also. So they live in the water. Now, the hatchlings will live up in the reeds, and you very rarely see them. But the adult turtles, by the time they've reached maturity, they have very few predators. Now, let's have a look at a snake-necked turtle versus a short-necked turtle, or a long-necked turtle versus a short-neck. Now, the snake-necked turtle uses its neck, and it folds it back like this, and it actually hunts tadpoles, small fish, invertebrates, whereas short-necked turtles, they can't strike out like that, and they don't hunt, typically. They're actually garbage cleaners. Now, that shouldn't make them sound grubby. They actually provide a really important ecological service. When something dies under the water, and it could be diseased, those turtles clean it up, and they keep the waterways clean. And whether that's with bits of fruit or leaves or debris that comes in that they eat, they help clean the waterways. They're a really important function. Freshwater turtles are typically solitary. However, they live in groups. So within a deep hole, within a waterway, you could have 20 turtles, but they don't hang out together or go to school together or have community meetings. They're typically solitary. Smaller turtles will be in the less preferred spots of the waterway, up in the reeds, hiding. The bigger mature turtles, it's really common to find them around something like a big log that's fallen in the water, and they use that log for a bit of shelter. Now, when it comes time for breeding, and noting that so many of our freshwater turtles have been on Earth basically unchanged since the age of dinosaurs, and even before, 80 million years ago. Now, when they breed, they mate underwater, a male and a female. And once they've mated, the female then has fertilized eggs. and she carries them inside her for about 2 months. Now, once those eggs are ready to lay, and it's normally in early summer, and in early summer, when we get that first big summer storm and lots of rain, it softens the earth. And the females know that's time to lay their eggs. So they leave the water and they lay their eggs. And those eggs are deposited in a nest that's about 10 to 20 centimeters deep. And it's another 2 months incubating in the sand, the warm sand. And then the hatchlings hatch. They don't see mum, they don't see dad. They make their way straight down to the water. And that's where they'll spend their lives. Australia has many freshwater turtles that are facing extinction. There are two that AussieArc works with, the Hunter River turtle and the Manning River turtle. And many of our turtles are facing the same threats. Now, one that is probably the worst of all is the feral fox. Now, the feral fox was introduced to Australia with Europeans a couple of hundred years ago. And when that happened, it brought in a predator that our turtles have never seen, they've never dealt with, they haven't evolved with it. So what's happening is that foxes have turtle nesting season. So all the females come up and lay their eggs on the banks. The foxes are going along and eating them. Almost 100% of eggs are being eaten by foxes. And what that means is there's no recruitment. There's no hatchlings making it back into the waterway, and the turtle population is all aged. Worse than that is females are being eaten while laying their eggs. Now, turtles, they sure, they have had native predators of eggs and females, but they're like water rats and goannas. They don't typically eat the females while laying, and they're not as clever as the fox, and they didn't get all of the turtle eggs. That's why they've been here for 80 million years. And in the last 100 years, and now, we've got our turtles threatened with extinction, and it's our job to stop that. So conservation projects are really important in three capacities. To collect turtles from the wild and have an insurance population. So if they go extinct in the wild, we've got them safe. Next is to breed lots of hatchlings and cut out the feral fox. So if we can hatch the eggs, then we can put the hatchlings back in the waterway and the feral fox can't eat the eggs. And the last is to work in situ. And in situ means with the wild turtles. How can we help them? How can we protect their nesting sites? How can we protect their eggs? How can we improve the water quality? And how we can help them to thrive in the wild. Two bits of homework for today. First is, I would like you to research and tell me how many species of freshwater turtle are there in Australia and what are their names? The next is, I'd like a drawing, but I want a bit of an ecological drawing. So let's pick the Manning River turtle. Okay, or the helmeted turtle. The Manning River turtle lives in one river system, and only one. And in that river system are other animals. There's a little endangered fish. There's an endangered crayfish. There's things like platypus. There's other bigger fish, like perch, brim, bass, and of course the turtle. Put it all in the drawing for me. And that's all for today. See you later. Thanks for watching, everyone. Now, the keepers and I are looking after all of our animals and our families, but we all have a bit of extra time at the moment, like you probably do too. So this is a great distraction for us and hopefully you. If you like what you've seen or want to show me your homework, just put it into the comments. This is what I do, connecting people with nature, and that can't stop. I'll see you next time.